Hello everyone, and welcome to another Company Heroes 2 Replay Cast. My name is ATR, and today we're going to have ourselves a 1v1 on Langreskaya. Our heroes today are going to be Nerbo, playing as the OKW forces in the blue. And his opponent is going to be Sturm Panther, playing as the Soviet forces in the red. So, back to it. Haven't been able to cast a lot, but that's usually the case nowadays, isn't it? So, probably no real point in mentioning it. So, let's take a look at what's going on. So, for Nerbo, we see Volksgrenadiers. Two in total so far, and I can assume a third one will be coming up. Thing to note would be if he's going to be getting himself a Kugelwagen before that or after. Nope, it's going to be a third Volks. Okay. And for Sturm Panther, he got himself tier 2 to start with, gets himself a second combat engineer squad, which is currently out on the field, and then starting the maximum spam. So has one out on the field now, second one coming up, and probably a third one after that. So for now, that's going to be the case. Over on the left-hand side, we have combat engineers trying to capture that center munitions, while we have Volksgrenz hold up in the shack across the way. Maxim machine gun popping into the shack behind them, going to be providing some support, but it does not have enough range to fight house to house, so it's not going to do anything to dislodge these Volks, at least not in a while. But it looks like, for now, it is, you know, not the important or, you know, doesn't really matter that much. And if you hear some knocking on the door, that's my kid that wants to get in. More Maxim machine guns coming out. We have the second one now out on the field, laying into that house as the Volksgrenz just move along. We do have that third Volksgrenz squad up in the north capturing the victory point. Storm Pyos nearby. We do have the supply half-track coming into play for Nerbo, so he's going to be taking up relatively quickly. Third 3-minute mark, so, you know, not bad. Probably going to be seeing the battle group headquarters, but it might be going for the mechanized for some quick vehicle play, so we'll see what happens there. And for Storm Panther, he is getting himself that third Maxim machine gun as we expected, now out on the field, and we'll see what it does. For now, Maxim's just moving along and popping into houses left and right. Well, more on the left than the right, really. That's one of them, is over here on the edge, trying to catch those Storm Pyos, managing to not do so, as the second one does set up and catch them behind. They do manage to pop themselves inside the house. Maxim machine gun getting flanked by a Volksgrenz squad and quickly forced off of the field. So back at base, yeah, the battle group headquarters is going down right at the main HQ. Gonna be making it a healing center at some point and not utilizing the retreat spot for it, hence it being built back at the base. So Storm Panther saying nice timing on the fuel, because the fuel over here on the right hand side, he was trying to take it, but it looks like he managed to get there right on time and deny the decap, allowing Nerbo to have, you know, a lot more time with the fuel. He actually has both fuels. You can see him on the left side over there, so Storm Panther not doing so great as far as that goes. Has himself, well, I mean, still not that big of a difference in supply considering the decap of this point. Does it still connect? It should still connect. Anyways, it don't matter. Maxim machine gun up in the north, catching the Storm Pyos, forcing them to retreat, disconnecting some points as we do have Volksgrenz coming up to reconnect the center points. Volksgrenadiers retreating from the south as we have another one hold up inside that house, and we see the flag half track coming into play. Flag half track pretty powerful, especially powerful against stationary targets like the Maxim machine gun. Should be able to move in and set up, get some shots in there as it packs up and leaves. So, you know, still though, we'll see how that works out. On the left-hand side, combat engineers with flamethrowers popping into houses, trying to flush out some Volksgrenz. Volksgrenz just moving around and taking some cover behind the hedges, making sure they're not being spotted. We do see some mines, no, wire, getting laid down there by Narabo that was never finished, but there is a demo charge. Wow, I'm all over the place. There's a mine right behind that. So Maxim machine gun up in the front, trying to hold off pin Narabo into the base. Flak Half-Trek just moves up right away and pushes them away, you know, without really any issues. Takes a couple of shots there through the front. And it does take damage because it is, of course, a half-track, not a tank. But, I mean, Maxim machine gun is not going to do as much damage as the half-track could do at all. So, yeah. Left-hand side, combat engineers and the Volkswagens fighting. The Volkswagens are in heavy cover with their sandbags, but that actually puts them at a disadvantage here against the flamethrower. The flamethrower is going to be doing some additional damage there. There you go. Getting three kills in total. Down to one man on the retreat. Can they actually pick up the one-man kill? The flamethrower can do some extra damage, but with only one man able to shoot at range, it should be able to make it out of there alive unless anything intercepts it. But it will not, so it will stay alive. AT gun now on the field for Storm Panther. Going to be trying to fend off against the half-track. The half-track is moving straight into the range of it. However, the AT gun is currently being moved. The flak half-track could potentially pick it off and eliminate it. But considering that it's way back at the base, even if he did manage to clear the weapon, probably wouldn't have been able to destroy it. Definitely not steal it, so it's better for Narabo to just simply move out of the way. Sets up right behind the house. Flak half-track opening up. We do have some mines laid down across the field, which is kind of dangerous there for Narabo himself because of the AT gun. Could accidentally detonate one if he gets shot, and that would be catastrophic for Narabo. Doctrine selection for Storm Panther, and that is, of course, the guard mortar coordination tactics. Good old reliable doctrine, or commander, however you want to call it. Gets himself a guard squad. Guard squad should help out a little bit against that flak half-track, but not too much. I mean, it can pin it, do a little bit of damage, but it's pretty quick there. Mine did get detonated over here. Looks like a combat engineer squad was lost, as we only have one left on the field on the other side. The Volks Grenadiers are nearby. Big push straight through the center there for Storm Panther, sending his guard squads all the way up to the north to disconnect that point. However, again, with the victory point actually connected, it does have a path towards the munitions and is still able to provide resources for the remaining territories. So, valiant attempt there for Storm Panther. Doesn't actually accomplish that much, at least not for disconnections. So we see the AT gun finally moving itself into the center to try and take that victory point. Maxim machine guns, though, have been set up right at the front of the base, so they will be denying the infantry from moving forward. We do see the flak half-track coming up from behind. Going to be getting some shots on the rear of the AT gun. AT gun going to be taking some damage, turning itself around to try and phase the half-track, and the half-track is moving along. Maxim machine gun is moving in a different direction to try and provide some support against the half-track, but it will get shot in the face there as the flak gun goes up. Gets the squad suppressed. Shots flying from the AT gun through the hedge, but unable to hit the flak half-track. And up at the front, the guard squads are getting overrun here, as we do have MG-34s coming out into the field for Narabo, providing some additional help against the infantry. The grenade does fly. Those storm pioneers do take quite a bit of a hit, but they're okay. Mines getting hit. Infantry getting killed. But no squads getting wiped, so no big deal. Over on the left-hand side, Volks Grenadiers and Half-Track able to hold out. Combat Engineer on the right-hand side, managing to capture that fuel point. Maxim Machine Gun getting that munitions, and now the resources are connected for Storm Panther. As in the center point, Volks Grenadier squad trying to go for that victory point, currently getting suppressed by a Maxim Machine Gun. Should be getting themselves pinned down relatively soon, as they are not in heavy cover. However, the flak half-track is wailing on the Maxim machine gun, so it will force it to retreat, which allows the Volksgrenz to hold their ground, stay on the field, and capture the point. Another Maxim machine gun moves up to relieve the retreating one and keep up the fight. However, point has been capped, so, well, no, nothing will really happen. Storm Pyle's trying to go for that munitions, gets themselves pinned down, forced to retreat. And on the left-hand side, we have guards moving forward right on top of that Volksgrenadier squad. Can they actually pick it up? Might be able to. There's a lot of damage going down to one man. There goes the Volksgren squad. And Storm Panther manages to finally pick himself up a nice little kill there, bringing things a little bit further in line. Now the supply half-track is on the field for Nurbo. He is crushing territory around here. Seems like he might be wanting to set up somewhere, although it looks like he's turning himself around to set up right there. So the Schwerpanzer headquarters is going to be going up. A little bit more aggressive than putting it in the base. Still relatively safe and able to cover the cutoff point up at the front. So not bad. Not bad at all. Making it a little bit less annoying. And we see the Maxim machine gun moves itself up to the front, fighting with the MG34 at range. However, the machine gun itself is not in range of the point, so it's fighting but unable to actually capture that victory point at the same time, which is unfortunate, considering just how close it is. Look right there. Like, his elbow is kind of into the point, but it doesn't count. Over on the right-hand side, Maxim machine gun inside the house, trying to hold off. Does get incendiarinated. The Volksgrenadiers get pinned down and forced to retreat. Second squad behind them hold up inside the house. The Maxim machine gun taking some heavy damage there to the flames. Will be forced to retreat eventually, as we do have a demo charge laid down on the right-hand side victory point. Back at base, we do have medics, so the squad should be able to heal up. And we see tier 3 coming down for Storm Panther to try and help a little bit against all this. Well, I mean, there's actually not a lot, but it could help against the flak half-track. Maybe pick it off with an SU-76. Or a T-70, if lucky. Back at base from the Schwerpanzer headquarters, Nerbo is building himself some Obersoldaten, buffing up his infantry forces, as he doesn't really have that much. I mean, combat infantry, there's really three, the Storm Pios and two Volks. So, you know, does need a little bit more, especially if he wants to be able to consistently get himself past those Maxim machine guns and able to, dislodge them. Because otherwise, well, his three troops are just going to get pinned down. Right-hand side, Volksgren squad retreating, unable to do too much. Storm Panther now controlling pretty much the entirety of the map, at least 75% of it. There's only a few points left on the field that currently Nurbo has in his control. Does move up with the MG34 and his Volksgrens, trying to fight here against Maxim machine guns and such, getting a little bit of extra territory. Guard squad gets itself suppressed here as the Volksgrens get right on top of them. However, they're still able to fight, and they do have DP light machine guns, so at that close range, the Volksgrens are taking quite a bit of damage. An ice grenade flies, forces a retreat. The guard squad manages to pick up its dropped weapon and then ends up retreating. Combat engineer squad moving forward. Storm Pios getting into the way. And they will do very quick work here of the combat engineer squad, so they do force the retreat as well. However, Maxim machine guns are on station and able to stop the approaching infantry. On the left-hand side, Flak Half-Track providing some support to the Obersoldaten. Obersoldaten do get upgraded with their MG34 LMGs. And again, we see an MG fight in the center map as both of them give each other suppression. And nothing really happens. Now, we do have a T-70 on the field for Storm Panther. Gets itself right on top of the MG34. Could potentially clear it out. However, it has managed to retreat and is running the weapon downfield quite a bit, so it might be difficult to take the weapon out of the fight. T-70 is trying to fight against all these Volksgrens. However, Flak Half-Track will be moving itself up. The weapon itself will be opening up on the T-70, and it is capable of penetrating that armor, as you see there. However, the Flak Half-Track itself is at a disadvantage. Rakuten Warfare does get built here for Nerbo. Storm Panther gets himself baited into the range of the Schwerpanzer headquarters. Loses its... that was a bad idea. Wow. Well, that's unfortunate there for Storm Panther. So kind of trying to retreat his tank. Instead of sending it back, he sends it to the right-hand side, running straight into the path of a Volksgrenadier squad, which Faust is in the ass. And that is not good for Storm Panther. Nerbo now in a quite comfortable position. We see Storm Panther building himself an SU-76 to try and help out again against the Flak Half-Track and such, but now loses that anti-infantry capability. Flamethrower on the combat engineers. Going to be trying to fight here against the Volksgrens. The Volksgrens are trying to capture that point. However, they are not allowed to do so, and the point will be left unattended there. Maxi machine gun be moved up to be the one to cap. Second maxi machine gun in the center retreating as the flak half track, well, does what the flak half track does. And the Sherpa Panzer headquarters also nearby, just providing some additional support. MG-34 does get picked up though by Storm Panther, able to make the steal. Combat Engineer Squad retreating from the center as we see more troops moving onto the field for Storm Panther. The 120mm mortar moving up. Gonna be trying to provide some support. And you can see the screaming of my kid as he's trying to get into the room. Anyways, AT gun on the right hand side trying to be utilized to capture that fuel point. Maxi machine gun at the front. We see the SU-76 exposing its rear to the enemy. And on the far left hand side, we see troop movement for Nerbo as he moves around with all his infantry and the flak half track. Well, not all of them. Back at the warfare in the center, managing to get a good shot there on the SU-76. SU-76 now forced to back off. Needs a little bit of repairs, but the combat engineers are back at base. They will slowly be moving in that direction. And we hear guard squads on the left-hand side being forced to retreat as the flak half-track is, well, on station. So a lot going on right now. A little bit of a lull here as we see Nerbo just recapturing some territory on the left-hand side. Wisely shifting his axis of attack as he was, you know, smashing his face onto a brick wall right here. Storm Panther digging in and having quite a lot of troops able to set up. The 120mm mortars just throwing some barrages in there, nailing the Joy Panzer headquarters. Will eventually destroy it if nothing is done here, so not bad there by Storm Panther, kind of forcing Nerbo's hand, forcing him to throw his troops into an attack, maybe even recklessly. Stolen MG-34, setting up to fight against the Volksgrenadiers. Volksgrenadiers moving themselves around, get themselves suppressed. The guards moving themselves right on top of them. They are capable of throwing grenade. Grenade does fly at the Obersoldaten. Grenade pops, and the Obersoldaten stay alive. Rip the guards into shreds and quickly force them to retreat. However, the MG-34 is able to stop the approaching infantry for the most part. Center map, the flak half track opening up on the infantry. We do have guards in the center. Shots flying at the retreating infantry, getting some additional damage, but should not be able to kill. MG-34 trying to hold the line against all these approaching infantry. The Volksgrenadiers pushing forward. They might be able to get themselves in range for an incendiary nade. Nope, they get themselves pinned down, so they are now just at the mercy of the MG. Quickly forced to retreat, and that's about it. So the AT gun combination with the mortar, they are able to destroy the Schwerpanzer headquarters, removing any of that tech available to Nerbo, so not bad there for Storm Panther. Does still have his battle group headquarters, and it technically doesn't really even need to be rebuilt if you wanted to maybe go for the King Tiger later on, but probably not going to happen. He still needs to get that mechanized regiment headquarters, so yeah. MG-34 down south fighting. We see the SU-76 pushing forward, trying to get itself in range of the flak half-track. Storm Panther desperately throwing away his vehicles, trying to take out that flak half-track needlessly, recklessly, and well, there it goes again. He did hit the mine, he hit Racket the Warfare in the face, and then all other things, and yeah, that's not gonna be that nice. Nerbo does select this doctrine, and that is the Elite Armor Doctrine, with which he calls in the big, the beefy, the chubby, or whatever you want to call it, the chode, the Storm Tiger, with the power to deafen the field. Oh! Nasty mortar shot there, lands right on top of an exiting Obersoldaten squad and eliminates all the members in one fell swoop. That must not feel good for Nerbo. Does move up with the Storm Panther. Storm Panther shoots. Boom! Maxi machine gun goes down in one click. And that is slowly but steadily going to be starting to even out the playing field here for Nerbo. Storm Panther doing quite well. Victory points are 219 versus 332. Currently in the lead for Storm Panther. Has himself a 100-point lead. But that Storm Tiger is a dangerous, dangerous foe. He didn't know about it, so, you know, that's easy to be able to hit the first time, but the second one is not. Flag Half-Track getting some shots into the center guards. The SU-76 trying as best it can to get some shots at it. However, it did have cover by the house, so the shots were impacting the structure rather than the vehicle, which is unfortunate there for a Storm Panther. As Narrowbush just simply moves himself back, and that Flag Half-Track is still on the field. It hasn't really done that much. It only has 9 kills. Veteran C1. But it's still there, still being a nuisance, and still forcing the retreat of a lot of things, so, yeah. So 4 kills so far on the Storm Panther, 13 seconds left on the recharge. We shall see how well Nerbo is able to guide that unit. Volks Grenadiers in the center, getting some support there by the Flag Half-Track, trying to go for that center victory point. Managing to cap it and slow down the bleed here for Nerbo, as he is now down to 184 points. Storm Panther might be able to just simply win it like that with victory points. There's a lot of threat on that Storm Panther, but if it cannot consistently clear out troops on a regular basis, it'll fail. Oof! Okay, so there you go. Second shot. Second Maxi machine gun down, collapsing the entire house and destroying the units within. Can we even see him? Yeah, there they are. Also destroying the weapons, so that is another unit off of the field. Orbital Soldaten moving around in the center, still being provided a little bit of support by the Flag Half-Track, holding that center point. However, with some AT guns behind it, the Flag Half-Track is not going to be able to just simply stand there and take what it wants. Gotta go ahead and put a hotkey on that guy. Wait, why it's not recognizing it? I need to switch and switch. There we go. There we go. So yeah, we'll keep an eye on that. Back at the Warfare Center map, trying to capture some points as Obersoldatens go behind the lines. SU-76s moving together over to the right-hand side, seemingly now wanting to put an end to the Flag Half-Track. Racket and Warfers are 2 in total, trying to move themselves forward. Managed to get a shot in the ass of one. Second one is not going to get a shot off as it turns itself around, but the SU-76s have been forced to move around. 6 seconds left on that Storm Panther. Flag Half-Track moving up. Going to be attacking the Combat Engineers as they retreat. And Storm Tiger is ready, so we'll see what that does. Racket and Warfare slowly crawling its way up into range of the AT gun, kind of trying to reveal it for the Storm Tiger. However, the AT gun decides to disengage and move its way back. We do have the stolen MG34 over here, apparently trying to go and hold its way into the house. No, it's going to be turning itself around to face the MG34. Oof. So, third shot flies, third MG down, as Nerbo is slowly but steadily just whittling away at all these defensive units that Storm Panther has. We see Combat Engineers deciding to tech up, get themselves tier 4 down for Storm Panther. Guards in the center trying to take that center victory point. They do manage to decap it, but the cover that they were behind gets demolished by the Flag Half-Track, and they themselves are quickly forced to retreat. Guard squads and Volkskrenz engaging down south, quickly forcing a retreat as well. But we do have the SU-76s around here, and the Storm Tiger does need a little bit of repairs. Left-hand side, Volksgrenadiers moving around, going to be trying to cap a little bit. We do have demo charges laid down here for Storm Panther. Will he be detonating it? He did, but one man remains on the squad, so the point will be lost. Nicely placed, nicely attempted, but it did not pan out, at least not in that instance. AT guns everything moving around. Now with tier 4 down, we do see the T-34s, 85s coming into play. Storm Tiger does need an additional 6 seconds. Well, 4 at this point, 3 now, and only 1. And now it is reloaded, so we'll see if it comes in guns a-blazing. Oof. AT gun going down there by for Storm Panther as Nerbo moves up his Storm Tiger and eliminates it. Does need to get a little bit of repairs going on that tank, although I guess if the T-34 catches it, you know, it's not really gonna make much of a difference. Oh, nasty shot there as the demo charge, I believe, got detonated. I don't think that was a detonation. Blows up, eliminating one of the Ragnar Warfers. Main gun does get destroyed on the flag. Half-track second shot flies and down it goes. Ragnar Warfers do get some additional shots on the rear of the SU-76s. SU-76 getting shot again. Faust will be going off. Down goes the SU-76. Does get dropped there on the field, potentially stolen there, although it looks like... Oh, well, it looked like Storm Panther wanted to actually eliminate the vehicle itself. Make sure that it wasn't just gifted to his enemies. However, it missed the shot, and now it's just sitting there. There we go. SU-76 does take the shot. Realizing that, yeah, there's no way I want to leave that on his doorstep. It's too far into his own base, and it would help out way too much. But Storm Panther is losing quite a bit of units and is now in... bit of a tough spot. The Storm Tiger has been reloaded. We do see the Volkskrantz capturing some points. Like the Warfer up in the front getting caught out on the field there by combat engineers and guards and all sorts of nasty things. We see the Storm Tiger just getting ready to face whatever it can. Volkskrantz rushing into the center. We see the Storm Tiger pushing forward, going to be throwing a barrage at the SU-76. Oh, but he needs to cancel it. Yeah. Turn it around. Doesn't look like he's going to be able to get a shot off. He's just simply going to be pushing the units back, I think. Boom. Shot does fly. Down goes the SU-76 in a ball of flame. So, yeah. This is getting kind of close there. Nerbo is down to 85 points, so Storm Panther is doing still a great job at holding him at bay and bleeding those points. But, I mean, Nerbo is slowly but steadily just whittling away his army. 20 kills so far on that Storm Panther. Does Louvre the MG34 onto the world there. We do still have one Maxim machine gun in possession for Storm Panther. Currently back at base, not a lot of them out on the field. We see another demo charge going down. The, Storm Piles are going to run headlong into that. That could actually be a detonation clear. Oh, yeah, that's going to suck. Yeah, that's a dead squad. Yeah, that's a fully dead squad. Nope. Manages to dodge out of the way. One guy will remain alive. If he had actually been able to see that. It was so sweet right on top of it. MG34 does get recovered here by Nerbo. Going to be running back. Well, actually, I don't think it's going to be running back because it's 3-man strong, so it's still fine. As Volkskrantz move over to the left-hand side to capture the victory point, and Nerbo tries to slowly but steadily push his way back into the base. 58 points left for him, but he has managed to decap all the points. The Storm Tiger, now fully, not fully, but now healed, being healed a little bit, and also reloaded, is in potential to be able to throw another quite damaging shot. Storm Panther has been bled down to 300. Still has quite a bit of time, so he needs to reinforce and recover. Storm Tiger makes itself known. Boom! Down goes the mortar. And the 120mm mortar has been removed from the field. The Storm Tiger did overextend himself a little bit. The guards could potentially button it down and maybe get it eliminated. Mark Vehicle has gone down on the Storm Tiger. We do see the T-34-85 coming up on the flank. Going to be trying to take it down. And I think that's going to be a dead Sturmtiger. The Faust is trying to go off there on that T-34-85, and it does go off. However, the Sturmtiger is quite weak. Faust continue to go off, and I don't think they're going to be able to stop it from killing it. Yeah, one more shot should be able to do it. Can it actually bend? Return the bend? Nope. Oh, manages to miss the shot. That's actually quite good there for Nurbo. However, there's nothing at the base to be able to finish it off, so the Sturmtiger is just playing ring around the base, essentially. Back at the Warfare is moving up, could potentially get in range to finish it off. The Sturmtiger needs to be able to reload, however, he can't. Now he's getting shot in the ass by guards. The guards are going to be the one to pin him down and take him out. They're getting penetrations on the rear armor of the marked vehicle, adding to the damage. Shot flies. Down goes the Sturmtiger for Nurbo, and that is unfortunate. That's a good pickup there for Storm Panther. Does have enough fuel for another one and near enough manpower, so it's not the end of the world there for Nurbo. However, if this dies, it's bad for Storm Panther. No! Manages to make it out of there, just barely. It's still damaged, still in bad shape. But it looks like on the field, everything has been pushed back, and Nurbo is not in great shape. Can't even afford to not spend his manpower to get the another Sturmtiger, so yeah. That might be it. That might be Storm Panther eking out the win there, taking out that vehicle. It was way too far out there into the base. It overextended. They get the kill, but not worth it. Not at that point, at least. MG in the center, pinned down, just sitting there, getting shit on. Guards moving over to the right-hand side, trying to do what they can. Volks Grenadiers trying to hold them off. We see ones with assault rifles also in the way, but nothing too severe. And we see the T-34-85 now out on the field as well. Well, a second one out on the field, providing some additional support. So another Sturmtiger is available here for Nurbo, but not sure if that can really do much for him at this stage. 25 points left. Does have one victory point, but without being able to cap the other one and hold it. All the infantry retreating back to base for Nurbo. So, last desperate attempt here for Nurbo, just sending everything into the center, slowly trying to see if they can get their way in there and maybe take the point. Well, that's not going to happen. With 11 points left and this amount of fighting, he's not going to be able to get to the point on time. The point on the right-hand side has been decapped. A GG well played does get thrown out there by Storm Panther. Probably won't get returned. But with 2 points per tick, we are now down to 3 ticks. One more tick will bring it to one. And without that, actually brings it to 0. So there you go. That is game. Very well played. And yeah, very nice. Very nice. I do hope you guys enjoyed the game. If you have any positive or negative remarks, go ahead and leave them in the comment section below. If you have any replays you want to send me, go ahead and send them to the email that I will put in the description. But otherwise, I hope you guys have a great day. Thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you next time.